from WBBZ TV Sports. It's time to beat the champ. Now, here are your hosts, Paul Peck and Sue Nowoitzki.
Well, hi, everybody, and welcome to this special New Year's weekend edition of Beat the Champ. My name is Paul Peck with Janelle Sabin and Hall of Fame bowler Sue Nowoitzki. We wrap up our month-long stay here at the Mancuso Bowling Center in Batavia, Sue, with, as always, our final show is always a fun format. We've got that exactly for everybody today.
Yep, we have mixed doubles today competing in our Baker format that we've seen a couple times now. So one person will bowl on one lane, first frame, other person will bowl on the other lane, second frame. Then we have friends and couples that have come out to compete tonight.
Yeah, so you got that. So you got husband and wives, Janelle, you got brothers and sisters. You may have to officiate a little bit here and stay, keep everybody behaving.
If I could do it at Malwitz, I can do it here at Mancuso's.
All right, so we're going to have a little fun. It's our final week stay here in Batavia. We're going to have some fun with the mixed doubles. So let's get rolling. So here we go with our first match of this special edition of Beat the Champ from here at Mancuso Bowling Center in Batavia. It is a mixed doubles Baker format. And leading us off is Penny Brown with a nice strike on her first frame, and good way to start things off. So Sue, explain to everybody how this is going to work as far as the format goes and the scoring is going to go.
Okay, so we're going to keep the ladies on the left lane. So the ladies will bowl the odd frames, and the men will bowl on the even lanes. So one will bowl one frame, and they'll just change frames.
Gotcha. All right, so now this is Mark Brown, and he grabs 9 pins here in this frame for the team of Mark and Penny Brown versus Jennifer Wagner and Rich Wagner.
And this is also a handicap format, so we will be adding pins to the Wagners. We'll get 20 pins.
So trying to pick up the spare here is Mark Brown, and he gets it. So it's a good start for the team of Brown and Brown, a strike and a spare, and now we get our first look at the Wagner squad, and this is Jennifer Wagner. Jennifer Wagner is from right here in Batavia. She's been bowling for about the last 6 years as she joins her husband, who is an outstanding bowler here. We'll tell you a little bit about Rich Wagner in a moment, because Beat the Champ bowlers will be familiar with Rich, particularly from our first week stop here in Batavia. So Jennifer's second throw is coming up here in the first frame. We've done this a few times before with the mixed doubles, and it's always a fun approach for things. And
yeah, and it gives,
always,
you know,
adds a layer of competition to the always friendly husband and wife and brother and sisters.
Yeah, it gives someone, you know, who watches Beat the Champ, but gets a chance to be on Beat the Champ.
So here's Rich Wagner. Rich is from, again, right here in Batavia, 33 years old, a correction officer. And Rich was our first bowler in the first show here from Batavia. He won his first two matches in the regular Beat the Champ competition, and then before losing to Pat Brick in the third show. So Rich is quite an accomplished bowler of himself. And to give us a little more insight into the format and to the bowlers themselves, we welcome in Mike Spator, the manager from here at Mancuso's Bowling Center. And Mike, thanks for joining us on here. Why don't you give us a little bit of an early idea about what inspired you guys to come up with this format for our always fun fourth exhibition show, and how you were able to pair all these guys and gals up together?
Oh, thank you. Thank you for having me. We have a pretty good mixed couples league here on Saturday nights at bowls every other week, and it's gotten to be more recreational, so we thought it'd be fun to have like a mixed couples. We do run an annual King and Queen tournament, and we do have a very good response, so we thought we'd take, you know, our house bowlers and showcase them for this event. So we had a qualifying on a Saturday and Sunday, and we took the top 4 teams with handicap to bowl today on TV.
Nice strike there for Mark Brown. He's got a couple of strikes in a row here as well, too. So the Brown and Brown team is performing well, and now we move back to the Wagners.
So all these folks are customers or league bowlers of yours?
Yes, they all bowl here in leagues. Jen and Rich bowl here on Thursday nights. Chris Bardall and his sister Jen bowl here on Thursday nights in a league that they sponsor. And also Frank had bowled in our mixed couples league on Saturday evenings. And Mark and Penny have bowled here various nights throughout the year on Thursdays, and Penny bowls on Wednesday nights as well in the ladies' league.
So this is a good way to showcase a little bit of that and give these guys a little bit of TV time as well, too.
Sure. We try to do something for the people that support us, and our house bowlers are a good indication of that.
So it's the Wagners and the Browns battling their way through the early frames here in our Mancuso Bowling Center exhibition match here in Batavia. Jennifer Wagner gets the nice spare.
Nice spare.
Good job for Jennifer, who bowls in that Thursday night league that Mike just mentioned. And now she turns it back over to her husband, Rich. 230 average for Rich, who bowls here on the Thursday night league. But as we saw, again, on our earlier Beat the Championship, he is one heck of a bowler, particularly here at this house. Is Rich one of the better guys that you have in your leagues here, Mike?
He's been the most consistent bowler that we've had here in a long time, dating back to when he was in the junior program. And he's averaged 230 consistently for the last 8 or 9 years here at this hall.
Wow, that's quite an accomplishment.
So now back to Penny Brown from Attica, not too far away from here in Batavia. She's a payroll examiner at the Attica Correctional Facility. And there's a nice throw right there to get things going in the fourth frame. And Penny with a cumulative average of 190. She's been bowling since she's 7 years old. Just can't grab that spare.
This feels like a good time to take a short break. We'll be right back with more action on Beat the Champ. Welcome back to Beat the Champ. Let's get back to the action here on WBBZ-TV.
So we're heading down to the home stretch of our first match here between Penny and Mark Brown and Jennifer and Rich Wagner. And now we move back to Rich. And this time it's the sticky 7 pin that holds up for Rich Wagner. Tell us a little bit about some of the other leagues that you guys run on a regular basis this time of year, Mike.
Yeah, we have leagues pretty much every night. We got a nice adult child league on Sunday mornings, one adult over 18, one under 18, which has taken off and done pretty well for us. And like I said, the mixed couples is big, and then we have ladies and men's leagues pretty much every night throughout the week. Mm-hmm. But our senior leagues are still doing very well. We have a Monday morning ladies league, which does very well, and the Friday morning 55 Alive league for our men, which does really good too.
So you're open here every day?
We're open here every day.
Every
we have
morning.
7 days a week. Christmas Day and Thanksgiving and Easter, my only 3 days off. So.
Oh, gotcha. That's it. Those are your only 3 days off all
three
year
days.
Long, right?
And then a little elongated in the summertime as the bowling winds down. So.
Sure. Another nice strike there for Penny Brown. She's bowling very well in this match. What can you tell us about the Brown team here, Mike?
Brown team's pretty tough, but seems like Mark's struggling just a little bit today. But let's see if he can make a few big shots here going forward.
There's a big one.
There we go.
Good one. Good ball by Mark Brown. So trying to keep things close here as we wind this down into the 10th frame.
I think there's a little nerves involved with the...
I'm sure there is. I mean, that's what I've heard from people walking in as they just come in for the first time and just see the lights that are flashing all the way down at them, the whole walk all the way down here before they even step up to even try to throw. So I'm sure it has a lot to do with it.
Hey, the grizzled veteran bowlers say the same thing to us as well.
I'm sure
too.
They do.
That camera down the lane there facing you.
Facing you, looking right at you. You can't avoid it.
Right, another nice strike for Mark Brown. So one more in the 10th frame for a final score for the Brown squad. You know, and we had Rick Mancuso on in some of our earlier shows, and Rick told us an awful lot about the history of this place and what you guys do. But Rick, maybe people don't know that there's a restaurant connected here, tied right to it. Tell us a little bit about what you guys offer over at the restaurant as well,
TF Browns is it's a nice sports bar-themed restaurant. Great food, decent specials. And they do generate a nice little bar crowd early evenings and late nights, you know, for something to do.
Whether you're bowling or not bowling, right?
Whether you're bowling or not bowling, yep. The restaurant's always open just like we are. It does a nice, it complements it very nice as far as the bowlers go in and afterwards have a meal, have a drink, and hang out.
Do you have a lot of Bills fans out here?
We do have a lot of Bills fans. It's a big Bills community. They run specials on game days on Sundays with a few of the beer distributors. And
so the Browns post up a 205 final score, and here is Jen Wagner. And then we'll finish off with her husband, Rich Wagner. And looks like the Wagners are going to advance on here, Sue. Yes or no?
Well,
help me out. Maybe
well,
not.
Well, we got to wait and see how this finishes
out. All right, because of the handicap, that's what
the
I didn't
right,
know
the
right
handicap.
Off the bat.
Because the Wagners are getting an extra 20 pins.
Jen, a little disappointed there. You could see
very
that she
close.
Didn't line that up right. So now it's up to Rich.
So Rich can only strike out for 200. So,
the Browns
are going to move on. The strike in the ninth, it's the builder frame with the three strikes in the tenth.
That's
the
foundation frame.
Foundation or builder. You're right. Either one.
Right. See, that's what drives me crazy about all this bowling lingo is that you call it one thing at Transit Lanes, they call it another in Tonawanda,
right.
They got a third thing in Batavia, and when you say one thing, all the other bowlers think you're nuts and you got it wrong, even though it might count somewhere else that way.
She's just seeing if you're paying attention, that's all.
All right, I got it.
Just like the sleeper pin, it can be a soldier pin. There's different names for it.
You know, but before I get done with this whole thing, I'm going to go on a crusade to get these things to all have the same name. Wherever we go, to come up with one set of solid lingo.
For some people, it's a clothesline. For some other people,
see,
it's a picket fence.
You're confusing me even more. You're confusing me even more.
My clothesline is your picket fence.
All right, well, I'm sticking with the picket fence, though. So we got a final score on the board. It is a 205-179 win for the Penny and Mark Brown team over Jennifer and Rich Wagner. So they will advance on to our next match where they'll take on Lori Morganti and Frank Jarkowitz. So give me the early handicap on this one here, Mike.
I think the way that it shapes out, I believe the Jarkowitzes are going to get a few pins from the Wagners, so it'd be about 10 or 15 pins or so, I think, that is the way it's going to work out.
Got to remember that handicap.
That's right. Got to remember the handicap. So we'll have that match for you when we continue. It's our special edition of Beat the Champ here at the Mancuso Bowling Center in Batavia. We're back right after this. Well, Mark and Penny Brown advance, which means Rich and Jen get to start your New Year's celebrations a little bit earlier. But who do we have with us here?
We have Gavin and JC, our two kids. We have 10 and 7.
They look great. They look like they are ready for New Year's. Did you enjoy this? Did you enjoyed bowling with Rich?
We enjoyed it. Rich has a little advantage over me, but we enjoyed it. We did.
Yeah, this was a nice little month for you. You started off with a couple of nice wins here, and you get to finish it up this way. Did you have fun during the experience?
Oh, it was a great time. You know, I enjoyed this just as much, if not even more. I mean, just being able to do this, you know, with Jen, you know, made it all worthwhile.
All right, that's great. And having the kids here to watch it as well, too. Yeah, hey, so thank you guys very much. Happy New Year's to you guys as well, too. We've got our second match of our special edition here at Mancuso's Bowling Center in Batavia. It is coming up next right here on WBBZ-TV. It's our second match of the day here, and it features the Browns. Penny and Mark will battle it out with Lori Morganti and Frank Jarkowitz. And the winner to move on to our championship match in our mixed doubles Baker format here in the exhibition fourth edition of our stop in Batavia. And much like she did in her first match, Penny Brown is off to a great start, Sue.
Yep.
It's, I said, you got to pick the right partner.
Yep, as husband Mark joked a little bit before we started, it's a good thing my wife's carrying us, carrying the team here today. So Mark held his own pretty well in that first match as well, too. So the couple from Attica, New York, will try to string a couple of wins together here.
So they gave away 20 pins in the first match and still managed to win. And in this match, they're giving away 13 pins. So, I mean, the other team's going to have an advantage of 13 pins of handicap.
At Beat the Champ TV and hashtag Beat the Champ on Twitter, and make sure you like us on our Beat the Champ Facebook page. Everything on there to get you ready for our next week's stop at the Jamestown Bowling Company. You'll have the qualifying order, you'll see the competitors list, everything will be there and available for you, and then any future details on upcoming qualifiers is going to be available there on the Facebook page. And a little frustration there from Mark Browns, he can't get that spare to go. So now we get our first look at team number two here of Lori and Frank. Both regular bowlers here at the Mancuso Bowling Center and have teamed up for this mixed doubles Baker format competition. And here's Lori from Bergen, New York. And a good first throw there as well, too. We welcome back in Mike Spator, the manager here at the Mancuso Bowling Center, and you can give us a little insight on the team of Lori and Frank here, Mike.
Yes, Frank and Lori qualified, and they were the second. Frank and Lori qualified here, and they bowl out of Bergen predominantly. Frank bowled here in some mixed couple stuff a few years back on Saturdays, and he plays down and in, and Lori throws a nice ball. She is quite a bit nervous. I did talk to her earlier, and I think this is getting the best of her going forward. So.
Well, so maybe it takes a couple of frames to relieve the nerves a little bit. That's understood. We've seen the best of the Buffalo Bowlers get a little nervous here in their debut appearances.
Absolutely. I would be nervous, too.
So here's Frank Jarkiewicz from Byron, New York, 46 years old.
Great shot.
Cumulative average of 203. As you mentioned, bowls a little bit here, as Mike mentioned. Also bowls at the Rose Garden Bowl down in, is that in Byron or in Bergen?
In Bergen.
So a good throw for Frank, and now we move back to the red hot Penny Brown. And as you can tell, as part of this Baker format, we're alternating men and women on one lane and alternating shots and alternating frames here, right? Did I get that right?
Yes.
I'm starting to learn this stuff,
still,
huh?
It still makes one game, so that's what makes it interesting, is that there are two people creating one game.
Right. There you go. Now you've confused me again, just when I thought I had it figured out.
Another challenge this later in the day is the lanes do break down quite a bit, so they start to hook a lot more. And it's a little more of a challenge to keep the ball on the right-hand side of the head pin.
So a nice spare pickup there for Penny, who bowls here on Wednesday nights and then bowls on Sundays in at the Leroy Legion lanes. Her high score is a 289. Husband Mark has had a couple of 300 games in his career. And a nice throw right there. Good strike for Mark. And now we move back over to the team of Lori and Frank. Lori's been bowling for about 18 years, cumulative average of 170 for her. Bowls in the regular league, as I mentioned, every other Saturday at the Rose Garden Bowl, and averages 168. And she believes, and she's got one of the highest averages ever for a woman at the Rose Garden Bowl.
Again, they're not used to seeing lane conditions that are, you know, as bowled on as this pair has been bowled.
Correct.
On. So,
and a lot of games.
Yeah, well, I mean, people, you know, remember, even though these shows get spaced out over the course of a month, we actually tape all of these shows in one day. So off the top of my head, how many games have we had bowled on these frames?
Well, with practice and everything else, it's a tremendous amount of games.
Yeah, you know, we've had 3 weeks of competition at three matches per competition just in the part that you've seen over the last 3 weeks on TV here, so. So as we always get towards the end of the day here, the lane conditions do start to get a little trickier. Hey, I seem to bother Frank.
Frank's figuring him out.
Frank's got it all figured out.
He's one that he likes hook, though. The way he throws the ball, he plays pretty straight, pretty direct, so.
He's got a lot of shine on the ball. That's the other thing that makes the ball go further down the lane. Keeps it from hooking is the shiny ball.
And another good throw for Penny, who is past achievements for her include a Genesee Region Doubles Championship, women's high average for 7 years, New York State Fireman's Doubles Champion, tournament champion of the Gladys Ford Memorial back in 2014, and in the Genesee Region Hall of Fame. So it's been a wonderful career bowling for Penny Brown of Attica, New York. She has been outstanding here today. No, not to diminish any of husband Mark's achievements. He's got a nice list of them too. New York State Fireman's Team Champion, Scratch Champion twice, and New York State Fireman's Doubles, and Leroy Scratch Doubles. So he's got a nice little resume going on his bowling as well too.
Great shot.
Yeah, nice smooth stroke. You can see that.
Shot.
Great rotation. So, Mike, do the bowlers in general, we talked a lot about this as the show went on with the natural wood lanes here. Do the bowlers like the surfaces here? Is this a good place where they get comfortable, you know, pretty quickly?
Yeah, depending on who you are. I mean, they say the wood lanes are a little bit tougher than synthetics. I mean, they do break down quicker at a more fast pace. Richie, being on the left side, I mean, plays way outside of most of the other guys, so his area doesn't really change. But the righties seem to find a tough time playing up 10, where predominantly the track area is. They find themselves a lot of over-under, which you would call.
We're going to be back with more Beat the Champ bowling action in just a minute. Welcome back to Beat the Champ. Let's get back to the action here on WBBZ-TV.
Got that one inside of his target.
I think, Mike, one of the interesting things that we talked a little bit with Rick about is this is such an unusual community in that you have a good core of people that live in the city of Batavia and in the town of Batavia, and then you start to get into a little more of the countryside, a little more of the rural farmland, and I know that's
definitely
such a big part of the economy around here as well, too. And do you see that in the kind of bowlers that you get here, that you have a nice mix of people?
Yes, it's a very diverse mix. There's a lot of, we have a league on Wednesday nights here, the Polish Falcons League, and it's a short season league. They bowl 26 weeks, and part of it is like because the farmers, they don't start till October, so it gives them an extra month from the typical bowling season to finish up their crop, and then they end up a little bit earlier, gets them out on the fields a little bit earlier, so it helps out.
Are farmers good bowlers?
They have fun, let's put it that way. They know how to have fun.
That's a tough profession. It's a tough life, and to get off, let a little steam off here at Mancuso's and bowling is probably a big part of their
life
as well, too. Yeah, as we were kind of joking that, it's a little hard to find the lanes here. And as in my travels in doing kind of a loop around the block, all of a sudden I not that I didn't run into it, but there was a big harvester and a combine there parked right behind the parking lot. So I'm like, oh, you don't see that every day when you're looking for a bowling alley. So.
Yep, it's a hidden gem.
Because it doesn't take too much to get too far out of Batavia when you really are into the farmland.
Yes, yeah, that doesn't take long at all.
You know, think about it. Here you are half an hour between Buffalo, half an hour between Rochester. That's what's kind of unique about this part of upstate New York is you've got big cities and you've got suburban areas, and then here you go, you're right in the middle of farmland here.
Right.
So we're winding things down here in match number two. It's Penny and Mark Brown versus Lori Morganti and Frank Jarkiewicz, the winner of this match, to bowl for the championship against Jennifer and Chris Bardahl. Oh, Penny Brown is on fire.
That was
right
a great
now.
Shot.
So even with the pins that they're getting, Sue, the Browns are doing a nice job here.
Uh-oh.
as you take a look at the updated scoreboard. Janelle Sabin doing a great job as always, keeping us up to date on the Castellone of Batavia Chrysler Dodge Jeep Ram scoreboard.
Oh.
Oh, Mark just can't get that corner pin to go down.
He couldn't have thrown that any better. He hit his target. He got the ball to the right like he wanted to. Just a tough leave.
So what's been kind of fun about this setup, Mike, is in mixed doubles, we've had husband and wives. We've had friends here in Frank and Lori. And then we're going to have brothers and sisters in a final match with Jennifer and Chris.
That could get tough, you know. I mean, wives have to get along. Brother and sisters, there's always that sibling rivalry. So
you're telling Stick and Beat, stay tuned.
It could be a little tough, you know, one way or the other. We'll see who outlasts one another on that one.
Could be some New Year's Eve fireworks coming up in the final match, is what you're saying. Yeah, well, that's what I know you and I have enjoyed about these final of our four matches on our stops each month is we leave it up to the proprietors and the folks that run the bowling centers to come up with how they want to have fun with it and how they want to honor their own bowlers. And we've seen mixed doubles, we've seen in-house tournaments, we've seen mom and dad and dad and son and kids on Father's Day, and we've seen the blind bowlers, which was such a memorable event that we had over at Classic, I believe, and it's been a lot of fun. We've got a nice little variety here, and we've got some great ideas working for 2017 as well, too.
One thing that's been consistent all along, though, is how much fun the people have in this one. The normal Beat the Champ competition is a little bit more serious, a little bit more intense, and these are always people laughing and, you know, the other side of bowling, like the part that people are entertained by and come in and have a good time.
That's what keeps it going.
So you get a little bit of both. You see somebody, you see what's really good, the very talented, the skill, and then you see the entertainment side, the fun side.
And a nice fair pickup there for Lori Morganti. Now she'll turn it over to partner Frank. So we're heading down the final stretch here, Sue. What's our update?
Well, Lori and Frank are going to win this, and they would have probably won it without the 13 pins. They would have won this
straight up.
So Frank will finish things out, and we had a nice little run of two matches for the Browns. And boy, Penny Brown bowled really well, and so did Mark. But Lori and Frank a little bit better in this match. And they are going to advance on to our championship. You see the 193 on the board for the Browns. Frank didn't like that, but it won't make too much difference as it will still result in a victory for Lori and Frank. And they will advance on with a win in this one. And they're going to get to bowl for the championship. So we saw some good bowling from Lori and Frank.
Yeah, we did. We saw some good bowling out of everybody, actually. It was nice to see the ladies come out, because we don't get to see too many ladies on this show.
That's right.
And actually show that ladies are good bowlers, too.
Well, we got to work on that, and I know you're working on that as well, too. All right, so give us a little bit of preview of this championship match, Mike.
It's going to be a good one, but we'll see what the Bardal siblings have to bring to the table here, whether you be in the number one seed and all.
All right, so the number one seed Bardals will take on Lori and Frank. That's our championship match here in our final exhibition event here at the Mancuso Bowling Center in Batavia. We will talk to the Browns when we come back and get you ready for our championship match. It is Beat the Champ on the road in Genesee County. We're back right after this. A nice little run for the Browns here. Penny and Mark, you guys wind up winning a match, and then you ran into a couple of good bowlers there as well, too. But, boy, you were outstanding, Penny. You bowled very well.
I know. I'm shocked, actually.
Why?
Because I haven't been bowling well lately, and I've lost my competitiveness, I think, the past couple years. I'm more into my grandson, as you know.
Oh, yeah.
But he's the bowler.
Right. Well, whatever you did, you rubbed off on her really well, Mark.
Yeah. She definitely carried us. I wasn't comfortable with the shot. I'm a down and in player, and they were pretty dry here, so I had to move in, and I made a lot of mistakes because I'm not used to playing in there, and thank God for you.
Yeah.
No, I kicked your butt.
Well, I could not have said it any better, but thank you guys for being a part of this. It was a lot of fun. It was great to meet your grandson as well, too, our biggest Bolt Beat the Champ fan, and we can't wait to see him again. So thank you.
We're fans. We'll watch it every week.
Thank you guys for the support very much. We've got our championship match. It is coming up next right here on Beat the Champ. It's the championship match here at Mancuso's Bowling Center as part of our Mixed Doubles Baker Format Tournament. And it's going to be Jennifer Bardahl leading it off for the team of her and her brother Chris Bardahl, taking on Lori Morganti and Frank Jarkowitz. And a good start there for Jennifer Bardahl. So we'll continue the same format that we've been bowling, and we will crown a champion at the end of this one.
That was a good shot by Jennifer right out of the gate. Hit the pocket. Left that all-familiar 10-pin.
Could not pick up the spare, so now we get our first look at brother Chris Bardahl. Outstanding bowler, 230 average. Bowls in a number of leagues during the week. Has a couple of championships and collegiate titles in his past as well, too. So looking forward to seeing an outstanding bowler here in Chris Bardahl. And boy, you can tell right off the bat there. So for a little more on Chris and Jennifer Bardahl, we once again welcome in the manager here at Mancuso's Bowling Center, Mike Spator. Tell us a little bit about the Bardahls, Mike.
Yes, this is the first year that Chris and Jennifer bowled here in leagues. They used to own a bowling center in Brockport Bowl. Their father ran for years, and they ended up buying a restaurant business here in Batavia, the North Pole. But Chris bowls on Thursday nights and does very well. They run a singles league within the league, and they're both phenomenal to watch.
Mm-hmm.
Do they both bowl in the league?
Yes, they both bowl in the league.
So is it a classic scratch league?
No, it's not. It's a handicap league, but it's a low handicap. It's 80%. It's a team handicap.
Okay.
And then they run a singles league within the league, which is also handicap-based, but it's division-based by the averages, how it breaks down.
So now you're looking at Lori Morganti, her and her teammate Frank Jarkowitz, the competition here, and good spare for Lori Morganti. And we'll get a look at Frank here in a moment as well, too. So how did Jennifer and Chris wind up as the top seeds in this tournament,
they
Mike?
They just outlasted everybody else and posted the best score going forward.
That's usually how it works, right?
So they bowled almost scratch, though, because they have only two pins.
Yes, they're only getting two pins.
So they're
it was a team handicap.
Yeah. So they're giving 35 to the other team, and 3.5 marks is a lot.
It's a lot to make up in one game.
In one game, right, in a single game match.
A little frustration there from Frank Jarkowitz. Couldn't get that 10-pin to fall, so he'll try to pull off the spare here as well, too.
Just out of curiosity, when you did the qualifying, did you have them bowl individual games, or was the qualifying Baker format as well?
No, they qualified regular game matches. We just figured for the TV, work out better for Baker format.
Now back to Jennifer Bardahl, as Mike mentioned, from Brockport, New York. 195 average. Genesee Region Women's Series record holder with 762. High score of 299. That's pretty impressive, 762 series. She's been bowling, obviously, as Mike mentioned, bowling's in the family, so she's been bowling since she's about 6 or 7 years old.
Good spare there.
And the same goes for brother Chris, also from Brockport, owner of the North Pole Restaurant and Party House here in Batavia.
Is that your competition?
Like I said, I mean, the community is very good, and we support each other. Mm-hmm.
That's nice.
Yep.
And you said the Bardahls are good sponsors of some of your leagues.
Yes, they are. They sponsor some of the leagues here, and we do a lot of events together with dinner and bowling and stuff we're trying to get going and work well together.
So Chris has got to grab the 10-pin here. There's Janelle Sabin manning the Castellone of Batavia Chrysler Dodge Jeep Ram scoreboard. And don't forget, coming up at the end of the show, we'll have our Modern Windows Word of the Week. You could win $5,000 worth of new windows, complete with installation from Modern Windows. That's at the end of our show today. Next week, a little trip down to the Southern Tier to Jamestown, to the Jamestown Bowling Company for our second visit down there to the fine folks of Jamestown. Looking forward to that. We had some great bowling when we were down at Jamestown a little earlier in the year, Sue.
We did, and speaking of restaurants, all the bowling centers are doing so well with their restaurants, and Jamestown, too, is no exception.
You just can't wait for that prime rib at the Jamestown Bowling Company you had last time, right?
Oh, that brontosaurus.
The brontosaurus burger, yeah. No, the food was terrific down there, and we're looking forward to it. That was when last time we were down there, it was Matt White came out of nowhere and rattled off 5 wins in a row on Beat the Champ, which still holds up as one of the best performances that we've had so far on the show. So we'll see if Matt tries to get back down. He's a Warren, PA resident, right. So it's a little easier for him to get to Jamestown because I don't think we've seen Matt since then other than when he bowled up in Lockport after he qualified up from Jamestown.
So. Correct. And he threw it very, very well.
Mike, you had a nice turnout here for qualifying for our competition that obviously we're wrapping up this week, but it was good support here in Batavia. We saw some great bowling, too.
Yes, there was. It was very nice to see, even through a little snowstorm that we had during one of the qualifiers on that Sunday.
How bad does the winters get around here? How much snow do you guys normally get
usually
around here?
Usually not quite as much as Buffalo, but the last couple of years, we tend to get some pretty substantial snowfall rates.
Among the achievements in Chris Bardall's bowling career, Lilac Series singles champion, intercollegiate singles champion, part of the Team USA Junior team in 2010, and a 3-time All-American at Robert Morris University. So an outstanding career, and again, growing up in a bowling alley and a bowling family helps contribute to that as well, too. Right, so if you grow up in a bowling family like Chris did, you're going to kind of go one way. You're going to either become a bowler or you're going to own a restaurant, right?
It's one way or the other,
isn't it?
Or both.
That's right. Because essentially every bowling alley is both, isn't it?
It is.
The action will continue on Beat the Champ in just a minute. Welcome back to Beat the Champ.
Hi, I'm Janelle Saban. We're at Mancuso's Bowling Center. We're looking to get some New Year's resolutions. What's your name?
My name's Greg Wolf.
Hi, Greg, and what's your New Year's resolution?
My New Year resolution would be to create happiness within my family.
I'd say that's a pretty good resolution. All right, and now I'm here with Kyle. What's your New Year's resolution?
My New Year's resolution will be to make Brian Borowski happy at least once this year.
Well, we had, as we look back on the year a little bit, one of the highlights of the year for you and I, Sue, not just Beat the Champ-wise, but was a couple of weeks ago, right after Thanksgiving, was the Hall of Fame induction ceremony, the Greater Buffalo USBC Hall of Fame induction ceremony, and it was a wonderful turnout, 300-400 people at Samuel's Grand Manor, 12 inductees, some of them, obviously you know almost all of them, some of them real near and dear to your heart. It was a really neat event that I was excited to be at, and the reception that we got as related to Beat the Champ was outstanding as well, too.
Right. I mean, for 400 people to show up to honor the 12 bowlers in Western New York that were going to the Hall of Fame, it was really quite a thing to see that many people in the room supporting, the other bowlers, supporting, people that they've known and grown up with and for their service as well as their ability. It was quite an event.
You remember when you were inducted? Remember your big night?
I was so panicking about doing the speech that the whole evening went by in a blur, just waiting for me to get that speech over with. And now you've got me talking every week on TV, which...
See, that prepared you.
I would
you.
Never have guessed this.
That prepared you very well.
But it was a really exciting night. And you don't realize until you go in what an... I mean, you know it's an honor when you get that phone call, but you think it's going to be this night, this great night where you get honored, but it carries on after that. I mean, even with Pat Brick, he's been, inducted in the Hall of Fame. Yep. Now every time we talk about him, we call him Hall of Famer. It's such an honor. It doesn't go away. Even after, just when the night's over, you carry it with you forever.
Yeah, it sort of moves you into a different class.
It does.
It moves you into a separate category of Western New York bowlers.
And it really is nice to be recognized for your accomplishments, and that's the highest honor you can get.
Sure is.
Back to Frank Jarkowitz. Oh, I got a couple of little pins, a couple of late falls there on a few of the pins. We're heading towards our crowning our champion here in the mixed doubles tournament here at Mancuso's Bowling Center in Batavia. Working our way through the stepladder finals. Jarkowitz and Lori Morganti versus Chris and Jennifer Bardal. Nice easy stroke for Frank, and he gets the spare.
Well, this is where you see where 35 pins and handicap can make such a big difference, because it's really hard if you're making your spares to ever make up 35 pins. It all is. You've really got to do is make your spares.
And there you see the updated scores with the pin handicaps built in.
Nice,
and a nice strike for Jennifer Bardal. Well, let's hope you don't have too rough a winter out here, Mike, and that there isn't anything that can keep the bowlers away when they need to get here, and they have to hop on the tractors to get them on up here to Main Street. They can do that, too.
They do that. They do it pretty well. I mean, those no school days when there's no school with us because of the snow, they still find their ways here.
And a nice strike for Chris Bardal. We've enjoyed our stay here. It's you guys have been wonderful, and the hospitality's been great. The support of the Batavia community has been outstanding, and hopefully we get a chance to come back here in 2017 and show off the outstanding work that you guys are doing here at Mancuso's Bowling Center.
Do you guys stay open all summer long?
No, we do close up. We're open through May and June, and then we close up July and the first couple weeks of August. Our golfers love to golf around here.
Yeah, there's some great golf courses out here as well, too. Yeah. You know, that's the nice thing about being where you guys are, is that you want to go to play some really nice golf course. You can go to Buffalo. You can go to Rochester's got awesome, outstanding, some of the best in the country golf courses. So you do get that benefit of being able to go, which way, east or west on the thruway,
right?
You know, Darien Lake's not far away from here either for summertime entertainment, and got a lot of fun options. Got the Muck Dogs. You can go to Rochester for the Red Wings, Buffalo for the Bisons. If the Muck Dogs aren't home, still one of the all-time great baseball nicknames of all time is the Muck Dogs. Do we know any of the history of how that came about?
Yeah, no, I believe when it was. I mean, they had a survey out with people that just come up with names. And I do believe it was just the most popular voted survey, you know, from some of the farmers, you know, on the muck, you know, in Elba,
far
up the road. And I do believe that's how it got its name. It was a popularity vote.
So we've got a final score posted up for the Bardals.
Nice shot. Just a formality. They've already won, but it is.
Lori and Frank are winners then. So as the handicap helps out an awful lot here on that one, and it's going to help Lori and Frank come up with the victory here. So Frank will finish things out. And then we'll get a chance to talk to all four of our bowlers. Hey, Mike, thank you very much for your time and your insight, and good luck here at Mancuso's for the rest of the year and certainly into 2017. And like I said, hopefully we're back here to catch up with you later on in the year. So
thank you very much. Thanks for having me.
Mike Spator, the manager here at Mancuso's Bowling Center, we thank him for his help, and they did a great job in setting up this final of our four-week stop here at Mancuso's with the mixed doubles Baker format championship that we're going to crown Lori and Frank as our winners, and we will do that when we return. We'll be back in a moment. This is Beat the Champ in Batavia, New York. We're back right after this. It's a win for Frank and Lori over Chris and Jennifer in the championship of our mixed doubles tournament here at Mancuso's. You guys look like you were having fun out there. You both look like you're pretty serious bowlers. Was this a good time?
It was.
Yeah? You like bowling with your sister?
Yeah, we bowl a lot together, you know, when we can. A lot of mixed doubles tournaments. You know, that's why something like this, a lot of fun. Something just give us a chance to get out and do together, I guess.
All right. Well, you guys were an awful lot of fun to watch, and so were these guys.
Yeah,
Sue.
Absolutely. And the 35 pins is nice to get, but you didn't need all of that, to be honest with you.
We didn't need any of them.
Was there any nerves today bowling?
Yes.
Yes? No. How about you? Nope. Have you bowled on TV before?
Nope.
No.
Nope. Lights didn't get you?
No.
Okay, well, I'm going
to. Well, there you go. There's the trophy. We want to thank Marty Hine at Joe's Awards and Trophies right here in Batavia for donating that championship trophy. You guys will have to figure out who gets to put that in the trophy case for, you know, split that up a time frame or whatever. But congratulations, guys. It was a lot of fun to watch you guys. Sue and I will come back and wrap up our month-long stay here in Batavia when Beat the Champ continues right after this. Well, we had a wonderful month-long stay here in Batavia. We had some great bowling, Sue. We saw some veteran guys. We saw some younger guys. We saw some guys from Batavia win. It was a lot of fun to watch.
It was a lot of fun. You're right. We did have a lot of everything here, and it was the perfect way to wrap up our year of Beat the Champ. So look forward to Jamestown and our next year.
Yeah, and you had to handle some pretty good crowds there, Janelle. The crowds here were outstanding.
Oh, yeah, it was great, and I can only hope for bigger and better crowds as we go on.
Well, we're looking forward to 2017. We kick it off as the show moves to Jamestown, as Sue mentioned. But before we get started and thinking about next year, a happy new year to everyone. A happy and healthy new year. Thank you for your support of the show, for everyone on the crew here at WBBZ, for Janelle Sabin and Sue Novoisky. My name is Paul Peck. Thanks for watching Beat the Champ.